I'm here with the Hungarian ambassador to the Holy See, Edward Habsburg, in his lovely office with Cardinal Vincenti, a great legend of the Hungarian Church, with us in the middle. Ambassador, I would like to know what your job entails. We hear about these Vatican ambassadors to the Holy See, but we don't know often what they do. Can you tell me a bit more about your job?
It's fantastic, and I had no idea, because my idea of being an ambassador is standing around on cocktails with a glass in the hand and not being able to say anything in fear of saying something wrong. It's absolutely not like that, but perhaps it's because of the Holy See. This is a very special place. I'm working at a place that spans, entails, in all its smallness, 1.2 billion people in the world, with a Pope that is incredibly engaging, reaching out to the entire world, helping, mediating. It's a bubbling place full of life, and you can play a little part as an ambassador.
So the Holy See, as you said, is 1.2 billion people, yes. The Catholic Church, but the Vatican City State is a tiny place. Some people say, is the Vatican San Marino or China? what do you say?
Oh, somewhere between the two of them. It is very small, local, and you can really meet people there. And at the same time, you always have the big story behind it. And you always have the world church in the minds of people you talk with.
And your country, Hungary, has been on the front line of the whole migration crisis. And Pope Francis has made opening the church's arms to migrants, or trying to get countries to be more open to migrants.
Yes.
Clearly, there's a bit of a diplomatic balancing act you have to play here. How are you going about doing that?
Well, first of all, I'm here to explain Hungary, so that's what I do every day. My impression is that in the Holy See, there is much understanding for the situation of countries like Hungary, who are sort of in the middle of the flow and in the first row. And I have the feeling with Pope Francis that while he encourages every Christian to be open and accommodating, he has absolute understanding for what being a country entails. So you would find quotes of him of total openness and then quotes of caution. For instance, saying a country should only take in migrants if you can be sure that they can integrate in your country. A country should also listen to the fears of their people, but at the same time, don't have too much fear. I feel a very balanced position on the side of the Holy See and of the Holy Father, and a readiness to listen. And our Hungarian way of handling this is trying to help refugees before they even leave the countries, trying to help the countries where they are in order not them having to leave. For instance, 2 days ago, the news came out that Hungary is going to invest several million euros in Lebanon to help Lebanon cope with the incredible stream of refugees there. So Hungary in its own way is doing its part, and I think there is understanding here. But as an ambassador, you can be a bridge between two sometimes slightly different opinions.
Now, I have to ask you about your own family history. You're a Habsburg,
yes.
And have a long association with Austria and Hungary. So does being a Habsburg get you any special privileges at the Vatican?
Well, unfortunately, they don't ask us for papal elections anymore. I mean, the last time we said something was Francis Joseph. And after that, there was a saintly pope, so it wasn't that bad. But honestly speaking, I think being a Habsburg is useful because you come out of a tradition of, first of all, being international. You're used to different countries and different opinions. You have a tradition of Europe. I think in our family we are raised to faith, family and Europe. And all of this is very useful when you face the Holy See.
So it's about taking your history or family history and making it relevant.
Yes, and making it relevant in the 21st century. Not looking back onto dusty crowns, but looking forward.
And finally, Ambassador, can you speak to us with some Hungarian?
I suggest I'm not going to speak to you. I'm going to sing a song for you.
Fantastic.
It's a Hungarian song, and it's about a woman that in the evening goes out to call all her children in. As I have six children, I always think of that song when I call my children for dinner.
Well, please.
Egy asszonya, kilenc lánya, hívja vacsorázni. Minden este kiállok a buga, el kell kiabálni. Now the names. Manci Pirisári, Mariska Rozzáli, Ella Bella, Juci Karolina, gyertek vacsorázni.
Thank you very much. That was fantastic. That's the first interview I've had with an ambassador singing. So thank you very much for your time.
Pleasure.